Okay, everybody, here we are, here we go. Today we're gonna learn how to make your clinch knot, okay? Your clinch knot. We have our yarn representing our line, and we have our hook. We all know what the hook represents. The hook represents a court striped bass, a 40 or 50 pounder, nicely hooked in the jaw. Okay, here we go. You take your line, your power pro. I like Max Quattro. And 25% thinner braid cast barter. You take your line, put it through the eye of your hook. Like so. Okay. Now you pull your line out. Now you want to make sure you take your index finger and your thumb and put it at the end of your hook so that you have a little space there, because that is going to be a hole and we're going to use that later. So at this point, we're going to wrap our line around four times, but if I was fishing, I would wrap it around five or six times. Well, for demonstration purposes, I'm only going to do four because the yarn is thick. So, like so. One, two, three, four. Now, we're going to take our tag and put it through this hole that we had our index finger and thumb. And once we put it through that hole, we're gonna bring it back through this hole, bring it through, and this is where we make our clinch. Now we're gonna start pulling the line down. Pull the line down till it clinches right there. Thus called a clinch knot, and it should look just like that. And we will cut our tag in, and we have our clinch knot. Now we can use this on a hook, or we can use this on a bow swivel. I have used it either way. I have caught several big fish, 20, 30, 40 pound striped bass, and it has never failed me. This is a strong knot. It will never fail you, okay? Look at that. The more the fish pulls on it, the more it clinches down. It locks. It locks at the eye of the hook, and it locks in the fish's jaw. And you catch us a nice size stripe. Okay, so there you have it. Your clinch knot. Take your clinch knot, your hook, go out and catch some striped bass.